Hello everybody, welcome to this next video on linear algebra. In the last video we saw that how we can compute the eigenvalues and eigenvectors of a linear operator with the help of the matrices. In this video we are going to do some examples of the same, right? So the first example I'm taking here is, suppose you have a linear transformation from R2 to R2. R2 is a vector space over the field R. R2 is a vector space over the field R. Not over the field C, set of all complex numbers. And the transformation is Tx, y is y, minus x. So this is your transformation. You can check this is a linear transformation. Question is, find all the eigenvalues of T. Right. Okay. So let us do it. So solution is, so you will do, we know that first of all you need to find out, step one is find a matrix representation of T with respect to any basis, of R2. So this any is important, that gives us the flexibility. Now the simplest basis of R2 is the standard basis, which is E1, 1, 0, and E2 is 0, 1. So I'm taking this. So step 2 is find A, which is a matrix representation of T with respect to this particular basis which you have chosen in step 1. So we know that for that we need T of E1, that will be T of 1, 0, that will be T of 1, 0 will be, you will have 0 here. Here you will get y is your 0, and then you have minus x here, x is 1, so you'll get minus 1 here. Now you write it as linear combination of E1 and E2, so this is 0 into E0, E1 plus minus 1 into E2. So the first column of your matrix will be 0 and minus 1, and for T of E2, that will be T of 0, 1, x is 0, y is 1, so you'll get y is 1, x is 0. Right, so your second column will be, this is 1 into E1 plus 0 into E2, so your second column will be 1 and 0, right? So your transformation matrix looks like, therefore A is equal to 0 minus 1, 1, 0, right? Now let us find out the eigenvalues of this A. Eigenvalues of this A are eigenvalues of the operator T. Fine. Now for this, for finding these eigenvalues, we know we need to do A minus lambda I, determinant equal to 0. So A minus lambda I will be minus lambda 1 minus 1. Okay, so minus lambda determinant equal to 0. This says lambda square plus 1 equal to 0. Now you see there are no real roots and our field is over R. Since there are no real roots, right? And we are looking for eigenvalues, they are in the field. Here we are talking about R. Therefore no eigenvalues here, right? If you are talking about complex numbers as your field, then you will get two eigenvalues, iota and minus iota. That we'll discuss later. But for this particular example, we don't have any eigenvalues. So you should know that there is a possibility that there is not any single eigenvalue of the operator you are talking about, right? So no eigenvalues. Okay, so let us look at the second example. So I have another example. I'm saying that, suppose T from R3 to R3 is a transformation which is defined by TXYZ is equal to 3X plus 2Y plus 2Z, X plus 2Y plus 2Z, X minus X minus Y. Right? And the question is, find all the eigenvalues of the given operator. Eigenvalues of the given operator. So again we'll do the same. First of all I'll choose a basis. Here I'm taking E1, which is 100, this is the standard basis, and the easiest one to handle 010, and E3 I'm taking as 001. Right, now I'll take A as the matrix representation of T with respect to beta and beta. For that, I'll take T of E1, that is T of 100, that will be 31 minus 1. So this is 3 into E1, right? 3 into E1, and then you have 3 into E1 plus 1 into E2 plus minus 1 into E3, right? And then you have T of E2, that will be T of 010. Actually, the example which I have solved is a different one. So, okay, so I'll just give you this as your homework. So, this will be 2, because I don't have the calculations, 2 E1. But anyway, we can do it now also, not a problem. Minus E3, and then T of E3 will be T of 001. That will be 2 minus 1, right? And this will be equal to 2 E1 plus 2 E2 minus E3, right? So your first column will look like 3, 1, minus 1. Second column will be 2, 2, minus 1. Third column will be 2, 2, minus 1. Right. Just a minute. I have done something wrong. So here this is 2, 2, minus 1. Fine. So this is 2, 2, minus 1. This is your matrix A. So if you look at this transformation here, right, so this is what you will get. No, I'm sorry, this is Z. So this will be 2, 2, 0, because there is no Z here. So this will be 2, 2, 0 here plus 0, right? So you have 2, 2, 0 here. Fine. Okay, now this is your A. Now if you want A minus, now you want determinant of A minus lambda I equal to 0. So that will be 3 minus lambda, 2, 2, 1, 2 minus lambda, 2. Then you have minus 1, minus 1, 0 minus lambda equal to 0. Right. So now you have to expand it. So let us do that. So you just expand. You'll get 3 minus lambda into minus lambda into 2 minus lambda plus 2. Then minus 2 into, I'm expanding along the first row. In your choice, you can do whatever you want. Minus lambda plus 2. And then you have 2 into, this is minus 1, then you have plus 2 minus lambda equal to 0. So you have 3 minus lambda here, then you have lambda square minus 2 lambda plus 2, then you have plus 2 lambda minus 4, then you have minus 2 lambda here, and here this is 1, so you have plus 2 equal to 0. So here this and this will cancel, so you have minus 2 only. So you multiply, so you get minus lambda cube plus 2 lambda square minus 2 lambda. Then you multiply with 3 plus 3 lambda square minus 6 lambda plus 6 minus 2 equal to 0. So this is what you will get, 2 lambda square, right? 2 lambda square, minus lambda cube first. Then you have 2 plus 3, 5 lambda square. Then you have minus 8 lambda, and then you have plus 4 equal to 0, right? Now you see, when you have such cubic polynomials, we don't have formulas like we have for quadratic, minus b plus minus b square upon 4 minus 4ac upon 2a. So here you will look for one root with hidden trial. Try lambda equal to 1. Here you will see minus 1 plus 5 minus 8 plus 4 equal to 0. You get, right? Because minus 9 and plus 9. Therefore, lambda is equal to 1 is a root. Right? Therefore, lambda minus 1 is a factor of left hand side. Now you can just use the algorithm, division algorithm, minus lambda cube plus 5 lambda square minus 8 lambda plus 4, divide it with lambda minus 1. So we will get the another factor. So this is minus lambda square. So this is your minus lambda cube, and then you have plus lambda square. So this will be 4 lambda square minus 8 lambda plus 4. So this may look basic for some of you, but it's okay. We can always try some calculations. 4 lambda square minus 4 lambda. So you have minus plus, so you'll get minus 4 lambda plus 4. Now you multiply with minus 4, minus 4 lambda plus 4. So you'll get a 0 here. So you get that this quantity on the left hand side is actually this into this. So you have lambda minus 1 into minus lambda square plus 4 lambda minus 4 equal to 0. Now you can further factorize it. So you'll get lambda minus 1 into, this is actually lambda minus 2 square with a negative outside. So this is lambda is equal to 1, 2, 2. So you get these are your three eigenvalues. Fine. So this is how you find out the eigenvalues of the given linear operator. Now you can find out the corresponding eigenvector. For that, they take lambda equal to 1. You see, eigenvector is a minus lambda I, and there is a vector u here equal to 0. So you are looking for this vector. Here, a, if lambda is 1, so a minus I, you see, just put a here. A is your this 3, 2, 2, 1, 2, 2, 3, 2, 2, 1, 2, 2. Let me write down 3, 2, 2, 1, 2, 2. Right, and then you have 3, 2, 2. 1, 2, 2, and then you have the last one, that is minus 1, minus 1, 0. Right, so minus lambda into 1, lambda is your 1 here, so into identity, so minus 1, minus 1, minus 1. And this vector here is x, y, z, which you are looking for, right? 0, 0, 0. So this is 2, 2, 2, 1, 1, 2, minus 1, minus 1, minus 1. Right, x, y, z equal to 0, 0, 0. Now you see these two rows are same. This row and this row, they are same because they're just multiple, not same. So you can just do R2 goes to R2 minus plus 2 times R3. So you'll get 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 2, minus 1, minus 1, minus 1, x, y, z is equal to 0, 0, 0. So you'll get x plus y plus 2z equal to 0. And another one you will get minus x minus y minus z equal to 0. Fine. Now you just add, so you'll get z equal to 0. Fine. If z is equal to 0, you'll get x plus y is equal to 0, and then you get x plus y equal to 0. So you get y is equal to minus x. So you get your vector x, y, z looks like x is equal to x, y is minus x, z is 0. So your vector looks like x into 1 minus 1, 0. So where x is any real number. So these are infinite eigenvectors. You can give any value to x and you will get an eigenvector. For example, if I take x is equal to 1, so 1 minus 1, 0 is one of the eigenvectors. Right? If I take x is equal to 2, then 2 minus 2, 0 is another eigenvector and so on. Right? And similarly, you can compute for lambda is equal to 2. So lambda is equal to 2 if you take. So here, similarly, you can get the eigenvector for lambda is equal to 2. So let me write down, you have 3, 1, minus 1, then you have 2, 2, minus 1, then you have 2, 2, 0, and lambda is 2, so a minus 2 I am writing, so minus 2, minus 2, minus 2, into x, y, z is equal to 0, 0, 0, so you'll get 1, 2, 2, 1, 0, 2, minus 1, minus 1, minus 2, into x, y, z is equal to 0, 0, 0. So this is the situation. So you'll get x plus 2y plus 2z is equal to 0. X plus 2z is equal to 0. Minus x minus y minus 2z is equal to 0. Right? So this is what you get. So here you get x is equal to minus 2z. Right? So from here x is equal to minus 2z implies y equal to 0. And here you get x is equal to, I think we are doing some wrong calculation somewhere. So if you are taking y is equal to 0, so you'll get x plus 2z is equal to 0. Yeah, y is equal to 0, so you get x plus 2z is equal to 0. That will give you x is equal to minus 2z. So your eigenvector looks like x, y, z. Here you see y, x is x, y is 0, or x is minus 2z. Y is 0 and z is z. So this is z into minus 2, 0, 1. Right? So these are the all possible eigenvectors corresponding to this eigenvalue, right? So this is how you compute the eigenvalues and eigenvectors of a given linear operator. In the next video, we'll move on to diagonalization actually. Thank you for watching this video. Please do share it with your friends and do subscribe.